just be.
We all moved here 3 years ago on the other side of Asbury, I guess, to kind of just start the band.
I mean, the last EP that we put out was pretty much, it was 2 years ago, our Afterglow EP. And it was pretty lo-fi, DIY, just kind of your typical indie rock, you know, record. And then we did a lot of work the last couple of years trying to change our sound a little bit or evolve. We started adding synthesizers and doing a lot more involved productions in Pro Tools. If you
a lot more layers, and just the overall vibe of it is really different. It's got like a lot more of a kind of 80s new wave kind of dark pop thing.
Long time relationships ending, and you know, that kind of fueled the fire for some of the you know, the content for the EP. And Chad was staying at in Bradley Beach, and it was just all recorded in the home studio pretty much.
The guys would come over and we would just you know, work on whatever demos I was working on at the moment. And sometimes we stayed up, you know, all night just until the sun came up. Specifically, I remember for Bad Dreams and Half Awake. Those were long nights.
I think we all started in that legendary New Jersey scene where everyone on the weekends was excited to go see a bunch of shows, and there was that real big DIY presence and young kids throwing huge shows. That doesn't exist as much nowadays, but Asbury is probably one of the last places where there is that kind of camaraderie within the scene, and it's, you know, very prevalent. You know, there's always music happening, so I think this is definitely the musical hub of New Jersey.
There's definitely a lot of talented bands here. One of the bands that draw a lot around here, I would say, Deal Casino. They're like awesome musicians. They put on a really great show. We play their record release show at the Stone Pony. That was probably, I feel like, probably like a bigger crowd than Barclays. But, or at least it felt that way just because it was sold out, it was packed. Demos that we record start from these like super simple scratch tracks where like kind of mumble in melodies or the lyrical ideas. It started really with this guy here, this Boss BR1180 recording studio. It's this little digital recording studio that I started writing songs on like years ago, but I still like to kind of use it as a, I guess, kind of as a crutch. But it's got this thing about it that's kind of, that's inspirational. I recorded a little demo for Lucid through that and into Pro Tools. This is what it sounds like. So it's got this really lo-fi, distorted, super ambient sound to it, just because for whatever reason I like hearing a lot of reverb when I'm writing melodies. But we end up turning it into a much better sounding production. It's actually kind of funny, like we'll take like samples from the demo sometime and actually throw it in random parts of the track. So this track actually starts with the demo acoustic and then kicks into the full production. So you can't really hear because it's doubled actually. Something is off. I can't quite understand what I've done.
time dreaming about her. Visions of what will eventually fade.